It had to be you that fell out, didn't it? It just had to be you.
So you're here then? I mean, I wouldn't mind, but you don't even bother ringing to say you're going to be late. I do have a home of my own, you know.
Don't start, Alice. I can't control the traffic, can I? And I had to get this lot on my way back. I'm sorry.
You could have got that lot in your lunch hour.
Well, actually, I thought I'd use that to have a sandwich and eat, if that's okay with you.
Hi.
You'd better take your mother home before I throttle her.
Like that, is it?
Like what?
Nothing. Hey, what happened here?
Oh, some idiot in the car park kept stalling, so I overtook him. I did it on the wall.
Susan!
Oh, so what? It's just a few scratches. Never liked the car anyway.
You ready, Mum?
I've been ready for ages. Good mood again, I see.
Why do they make these boxes so large when they're only half full? Stupid damn thing!
I'd better get you home.
See you in the morning.
Bye, Alice. Oh, by the way, did you remember to keep Ewan awake this afternoon?
Well, he was tired. I had to let him have his little nap.
But if he sleeps during the day, he keeps me up half the night.
The poor little mite couldn't keep his eyes open. I'm not prodding him awake all day.
Oh, no, well, we couldn't put you out, could we? That'd be asking far too much.
When I get back, you've got your doctor's appointment, remember?
Not likely to forget, am I? Not with you around.
You look cold.
I am. I'm sorry I was late. I made a fantastic chilli last night. I mean, loads of chilli. But then I spilt some of my work clothes, don't ask how. So I thought, I can't come in with that all over me because you don't want to go up people's noses and everything. So this morning, I'm scrubbing away and I think I've got it. Anyway, I completely lost track of time, got in, left the window open and now it's freezing.
I'm sure there's a spare heater in the staff room. Rana, would you do the honours?
How could I refuse? You know me, Kate. Never been known to leave a damsel in distress.
Sorry. Hello. Every month, regular as clockwork, about 3 or 4 days before my period starts, I get PMT, and it's getting worse. I'm so short-tempered with everyone.
What makes you lose your temper?
Anything and everything.
Are you violent?
No, I'm not. But I get depressed and angry. I can feel it welling up inside me. I've got no patience. People seem to rub me up the wrong way and suddenly I explode. I can't help myself. And then other times I'll just cry and cry. You know, I could be driving and suddenly I'll burst into tears for no apparent reason.
How long have you been feeling like this?
Seems like forever. It got worse after Ewan was born and I thought it was postnatal depression and that it would go away, but it hasn't.
Why didn't you come and see me sooner?
Oh, it's not a proper illness, is it? It's sort of self-indulgent thing. Well, at least that's how most people like to view it.
Premenstrual syndrome is a very real illness.
I've heard the blokes at work saying to a woman who they've just had a run-in with, oh, must be her time of the month. Amount of times I've heard that.
Your husband doesn't look at it that way, does he?
No, he's very supportive. And when I'm like this, I'm pretty nasty towards him. He only has to forget to put the loo seat down and I give him hell. And I think he just learned to keep out of my way most of the time. It must be hard on him. Gets him down.
What are you like after your periods?
Normal. My old self. Different woman. Just wish I could be like that all the time.
Well, we'll see what we can do. But first, I'd like to check your blood pressure.
Hey, stop me if I'm being too technical. You see this switch? This is off. And this is on.
That's amazing.
So if you have any problem with this, just give me a shout and I'll come up here and flip that switch.
As you know what button to push, next time I need warming up, I'll find you.
Right.
Look,
could be a hormonal imbalance. If you started taking the contraceptive pill, it might help.
I'd rather not. Never agreed with me.
Are you under a lot of stress?
Well, who isn't? I've got two young children and a full-time job. But like most families, we need the two incomes.
Who looks after the children?
My mother-in-law. She thinks I should stay at home and have a hot meal ready for Graham when he gets back from work.
You don't get on?
No, we do, most of the time. But we see a lot of each other. She can be right sarcastic when she wants to be. And when I'm like this, I take the bait. But she's good. We can't afford a proper childminder. And the children think she's great. And sometimes, though, I'd be getting jealous about the amount of time she can spend with them. What can you do?
You can get up now. I know what you mean. It's a juggling act. Guilt because you're not spending as much time with the children as you'd like. Frustration because you're not spending as much time at work as you'd like. And so very little time for yourself. It's not easy.
And on top of that, the PMT.
Vitamin B6 and evening primrose oil would be worth taking. And try cutting down on caffeine.
You're joking. I don't have my two cups of coffee in the morning. I'd be climbing the walls.
Cut down gradually and try and get some exercise. But most importantly, try and get some time for yourself. I know it's difficult, but we all need our own space. I'll prescribe you some mild antidepressants. Just take one a day. And if you don't see an improvement in the next month or so, come back and see me.
And if it doesn't work, just have to learn to live with it.
Not at all. It's an illness and it can be treated. Going out anywhere nice tonight?
Oh, chance would be a fine thing. I'm spending most of the evening at the police station taking blood samples and filling out reports.
No, you enjoy it, though.
Do I? I'm not sure anymore. It's hardly glamorous. By the time I get home most nights, I just want to collapse into bed.
No Mr. Wright in the background, then?
Well, if there is, he hasn't come forward yet. And I...
Where have all the clean towels gone?
In the airing cupboard. I put them away when I got home from school.
Thanks, love. Look at the state of this room.
I keep tidying it, and he keeps messing it up again.
Well, I want it cleared. And you, Mr. Bully Boy, you stop giving your sister a hard time, hmm? Do us a favour, Polly. When all this lot's away, can you get him ready for bed? Thanks.
Daddy.
I'm sorry, but I don't like taking the pill. It doesn't agree with me.
But if it makes you feel better...
Oh, I know, it might suit you. Look, I'd just like to see how I get on with the other stuff first. I'm not being difficult, Graham. I know I've got a problem and I'm trying to deal with it. But there's no overnight solutions.
How do you feel now?
Oh, not so bad. Coming through it, I think. Hope.
Till the next time.
There's me telling her how supportive you are.
I'm sorry, I just know how this gets you down. It just doesn't seem fair that you have to put up with this every month. I better get going.
Where to?
Portsmouth. Well, I told you last week I had to go there.
No, you didn't.
I didn't think losing your memory was a part of PMT.
It isn't! And I'm not forgetful or deaf, you just didn't tell me.
Then you couldn't have been listening.
Ewan feels sick.
Oh, great, that's all I need, another sleepless night. I blame your mother for this. Her and those weird concoctions she feeds him. Oh, then, go. Go on. Wish I could pack my bags and run away for the night. I'll be up in a minute, Polly. She's doing this on purpose. Getting her own back on me for being late yesterday.
Who is?
Morning, Alice.
Morning.
I won't be late tonight.
You've forgotten, haven't you?
Oh, forgotten what?
Ewan has to have his jabs at the surgery.
So get a cab. I'll give you the money when I come home.
I'm not taking him. Is your son something you should be doing?
Fancy going clubbing tonight?
Oh, no, I don't think so. Thanks anyway.
Going somewhere else?
No, it's just... wouldn't feel right going out without Justin.
So your boyfriend?
He's away at the moment, doing a cost management course.
Phew. Sounds interesting.
He's a sales director for a brewery.
Can he get any cheap beer?
Only kidding. So, you're not allowed to go out while he's away then?
Yeah, of course I can, but I'd just rather give it a miss if it's all the same.
No problems. But it is DJ Rush and he's only doing tonight.
Oh, really? Let me think about it.
What a little treasure. Not even any tears. Do you know how we got these?
No, I don't. Sorry, it's the first time I've seen them.
Their flesh is so tender at this age, can easily happen. And you've no idea how we could have got them.
No, I don't. I'm sorry.
He's looking a bit pale. Is he sleeping okay?
It took him a while to get off last night, but he's never been a great sleeper.
What about eating?
He's got a good appetite.
Keep an eye on him.
Well, I always do.
Go on! What do you think you are doing? Why can't you just do as you're told? Come on, just hold on for it for a change, please. I can't deal with this right now. Come on.
Yes?
Dr. Thompson, have you got a minute?
Yeah, come in. And it's Helen.
I've just given a 2-year-old boy his MMR jab and I noticed some bruises on the tops of his arms. Candy told me his mum, Susan Emily, is a patient of yours.
Yes. Did Susan say how he got them?
No. They were only tiny, but they were in exactly the same place on both arms. Like someone had gripped him, which rules out any stumbles he might have had. I don't want to read into this, but on the other hand, I didn't want to say nothing in case there is something wrong.
No, you were right to tell me.
He also looked a bit pale. He wasn't ill or anything, otherwise I wouldn't have given him the jab. Do you mind if I ask what you saw Mrs. Emil for?
Of course not. You're part of the practice now. Susan suffers from PMT.
Ah. I'll leave it with you then.
Okay, has Matt given any more thought to what we're going to do about Joe?
He's thinking about nothing else at the moment.
Yeah, well, he's not the only one. I'm not trying to be difficult, Kate, but I don't think it's fair keeping this a secret from the others. I mean, what if one of them finds out by accident what's been going on? It's going to look like a cover-up, and then how are we going
to
look?
Mike's trying to do the best for everyone, regardless of what he's putting himself through.
What do you mean?
He lies awake half the night worrying. The whole thing is dragging him down. The last thing he needs right now is people questioning his judgment.
Oh, hello.
Sorry, I should have called first, but I was passing.
Better come in.
The practice nurse told me Ewan was looking a bit pale, and what with him having the MMR jab, I just wanted to check he's all right.
That's not the real reason you're here, though, is it? I mean, your nurse told you about the bruises, and you've come to check him over.
Can I see him, please?
I've done nothing wrong, so why do I feel so guilty?
Could he have slipped while you were bathing him?
My mother-in-law bathes him before he has his lunch. Do you think she could have caused them?
Well, accidents happen, but I'd feel happier if I knew how he got them.
And what's that supposed to mean? Do you think I don't care? Do you think I don't want to know? I do my best. There's just not enough hours in the day to do any more.
It's okay. I know you're under pressure. Can you hold him a sec?
I still wouldn't take it out on the children. I get angry and I shout a lot, but that's as far as it goes.
I think he might have an ear infection. That's why he's looking under the weather. Give him plenty of fluids, and if he complains of earache or his temperature goes up, give him children's paracetamol. If he gets any worse, come back and see me.
And what about the bruises?
So where's this place we're going to tonight, then?
So you are coming?
If the offer's still open.
Yeah, of course, more the merrier. Grab your clothes for a moment at lunchtime, then we can get ready here after surgery finishes. We're going to the Opus Club. It's just off
Gillimore Street.
So you know it then?
Yeah, me and the manager are like that. In fact, if I come with you, I can probably get you in for free.
That's really sweet of you, but it's a girls' only night out. Sorry.
Oh, no problem. In fact, the Opus is a little bit passé for my liking, but I'm sure you two girls will have a whale of a time.
Dewey calls.
Ewan's got an ear infection.
I thought he was coming down with something.
Did you also know about the bruises?
What bruises?
On his arms. The doctors think I did it.
Well, you didn't, did you?
Of course not. I thought you might have accidentally done it.
How dare you accuse me of hurting my own grandchild? It's more likely to have been you when you're in one of your tempers, so don't you go blaming me.
You know I never take my moods out on my kids.
Oh, really? I've heard you shouting at them for no good reason. You've got a wicked temper on you. Who knows what you're capable of? I don't know how our Graham puts up with you sometimes. One minute you're nice as pies, next minute you're like a bear with a sore head.
I get PMT. I can't help it.
Look, I don't want to know about your TMP or PMT, whatever it is you call it. And anyway, that's something you ought to be keeping to yourself.
Oh, yeah, sorry, I forgot. Wasn't around in your day, was it?
Oh, why am I bothering? There's no talking to you when you're like this.
What's Faith about?
She's in the nurse's room.
Oh, yeah? Thought you were supposed to be at home studying.
Yeah, I had to get a couple of books from the library, so I thought I'd come in and say hello. Obviously, I'm not wanted here, so I'll go home.
Oh, don't be so touchy. Listen, I've got a ring of patient, but after that, why don't I get us both a coffee, eh?
I'm going up to see Faith. It's boring down here.
I'll tell Steve where you are.
Whatever.
Does Caroline seem okay to you at the moment?
Yeah, fine. What'd you ask?
Well, I was talking to her last night. Not that she'd tell me, of course, but I think she's feeling a bit lonely.
Well, Caroline.
We all need someone. When that drug rep came in to see you the other week, what was his name? Tim Morrison. I think Caroline took quite a shine to him.
What are you telling me for?
Use your head.
Since when have you been so interested in Caroline's love life?
Haven't you got anything better to do?
Wouldn't be here if I did. Faith? Have you got a boyfriend?
Depends what you call a boyfriend. No one's steady. I get more fun at the moment beating them off.
You're kidding.
I haven't got time for a boyfriend. I'm too busy enjoying myself. Take tonight, for instance. If I had a bloke, he'd want to come with me. I need space to strut my stuff, know what I mean?
You're going out tonight?
Yeah, I'm clubbing it with Candy.
Can I come?
Sorry, Nat, you've got to be 18 to get in.
Well, I can easily look 18.
I'm sure you can, but I'm still not taking you.
You're early.
I came straight back. What are you doing home? Where's Mum?
I took Ewan for his jabs this morning and they found some small bruises on his arms. So Dr. Thompson came here and checked up on him. They think I did it. And I think it might be down to Alice.
Why do you think that? She loves those kids. She'd never do anything to hurt them. She's my mother, for heaven's sake.
I'm not saying she's done anything deliberately, but she's old. Can you honestly say you trust her not to have an accident, no matter how small?
I don't believe this. I'm away for less than 24 hours, and what do I find when I get back? Doctors examining our son for abuse and you accusing my mother.
Well, someone was responsible and it wasn't me.
No.
What do you mean by that?
You know what you were like when I left here last night. You could have fought an army.
So you think it was me?
Look, I'm just saying that maybe, just maybe, without knowing it, you were heavy-handed with it.
And that's exactly what I'm saying about your mother. I was annoyed with you, not the kids. I'd never do anything to hurt our children.
When you're suffering from PMT, you're not yourself.
Oh, you pig.
Well, look at you! You've let this go on for far too long. If you'd have done something about this years ago, then our kids wouldn't be getting hurt now.
Bet that woman thinks I'm a right busybody.
You're right to bring it to my attention. Ewan's my patient.
I know, but...
What?
When I was a kid, I was always coming home from school with a new bruise. Kids get bruises, it happens all the time.
But not in the same place on both arms. There's a difference. And she can't tell me how he got them. That's why I'm concerned.
What will happen now?
Well, I've checked the family files. There's nothing to suggest abuse of any sort, and Ewan seems to be a very happy toddler. Like you, I hate cases like this. We have a duty of care to the child, but do a few tiny bruises constitute abuse? If we report the incident and it turns out it was a genuine accident, it could devastate the family. I tried to speak to the paediatrician responsible for dealing with cases of child abuse, but she's not back till tomorrow. So I'll speak to her then and see what she suggests. Hello? Thanks, Candy. Well, this is interesting. The husband's here to see me.
Why are you crying?
Susan tells me he came round to the house to check up on Ewan.
When he had his injection, he looked a bit peaky. I thought it was best just to make sure he was okay.
And to see if we were mistreating him, yeah? Me and Sue have had words. She hit me. She's never done that before, and it frightens me. The vitamins and medication you put her on, they will help her, won't they?
I'm sorry I can't discuss your wife's case, but obviously we're addressing the problem. You don't think she lost her temper with Ewan?
No, I don't.
She hit you?
Yes, she did. But it's the first time it's ever happened in a relationship that goes back a lot of years. Look, can't you see this is getting worse? I thought that when she came to see you, it would help her.
Mom, you monkey.
Not now, love. I'm trying to cook.
But he's crying, Mom.
I can't come, Polly. He'll just have to wait for me. Look, you try. You try and cheer him up for me, yeah? Go on, there's a good girl. Hello?
Let's not talk about it, please. I'm just going to go say hello to the kids. Hey, what's the matter?
His ear hurts.
Does Mummy know? Why not?
Will we do? You're drooling.
Good grief. You were saying?
Oh, it doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter.
Thanks. Shall we? Bye, everyone. Missing you already.
Bye.
Do you want some tea before you go?
I'd love one, thanks. Polly, isn't it?
Sorry, I better go and get that.
Are you worried about your brother? He's going to be fine.
Have the bruises made him ill?
No. Why do you think that?
I did them.
You did?
He was going to fall off the bed, so I grabbed him. I just didn't want him to hit his head. And then when I got him ready for bed, there were bruises all over his arm. I didn't mean to hurt him, I just didn't want him hitting his head.
Yeah.
How you doing?
I'm fine. Come to nag me, have you?
Well, maybe I would have done this morning. But Kate tells me you've been going through the ringer a bit, trying to decide what to do with Joe.
Well, Kate should know me better. No, I'm all right, really. Just trying to do the right thing by Joe and also...
Trying to do the right thing by the rest of us.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah, I know. Bye, Mum. Yeah, of course, yes. Bye, Mum. Sorry about that, Dr. Thompson. This is my mum fussing on the phone as usual.
I was speaking to Polly earlier.
She's been very worried about you, and
I'm more worried about her.
Why? What's wrong with her?
You've been putting too much responsibility on her shoulders. While you two have been wrapped up in your own problems, your 8-year-old daughter has been picking up the pieces. She accidentally caused the bruises on Ewan's arms.
Why didn't she tell us?
She was scared. Not that you'd hit her. I'm sorry, but I had to ask. But she knows how depressed you get, and when she heard you two arguing last night, she thought she'd wait till today to tell you. And when she got home from school and found you crying, she didn't know what to do.
We haven't given her a thought in any of this, have we? With me and the PMT and you working all hours. And then when we are home, all we do is fuss around you and... Come to think of it, Polly's the only one out of the lot of us who's never been any trouble.
We've taken her for granted, haven't we?
She's a very capable little girl, but she's only a child. You both work very hard, but your children need more of your time, and you know it.
Not much point paying a huge mortgage on a nice house if everyone's miserable.
So what are you going to do about it?